Greetings, brothers and sisters. God bless each and every one of you today. Hope everybody's doing well. Again, if you are subscribed to this channel, we are watching for our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Titus 2:13, looking for that blessed hope in the glorious appearing of our great God and Savior, Jesus Christ. Jesus is coming soon, and we're going to be watching on this channel. Again, we are not going to set dates because we do not know when that day is, but we very clearly see that day approaching, and we will be watching on this channel until the trumpet sounds at the appointed time, and Jesus Christ comes for his church. It's good to be back with you guys. I mean, folks, Jesus said the state of the world when he returns will be as it was in the days of Noah and as it was in the days of Lot. And just looking around the world right now, it's happening before our very eyes. We are living in those days. Folks, we are now in LGBTQ Pride Month. LGBTQ Pride Month is every year during the month of June. It's dedicated to the celebration and commemoration of lesbian, gay, bisexual, and transgender and queer pride. That's what LGBTQ stands for. Pride Month began after the Stonewall Riots, a series of gay liberation protests in 1969, and has spread outside of the United States. It's gone worldwide now. So yes, Pride Month is nothing new. However, this June 2023, which we're in right now, is looking to be the most celebrated, explosive, and controversial Pride Month we have ever had. I want to share with you some recent stories. Time does not permit me to go into all of the stories out there right now, but it's everywhere, it's worldwide. And then we are going to look at what the Bible says and how this confirms what's happening today is mirroring as it was in the days of Noah and as it was in the days of Lot. The first one I want to share with you is right out of Breitbart. Check out this one. Recent article titled, Glamour Magazine Puts Pregnant Transgender Man on June Cover for Pride Month. Here's another one my sister in Christ, Jan Markell, over at Olive Tree Ministries recently shared. It's actually a recent article from Gateway Pundit titled, Kohl's, you guys all know about Kohl's, I'm sure, is selling transgender-themed clothing for three-month-old babies. You gotta be kidding me. Kohl's is selling transgender-themed clothing for three-month-old babies? This is insane, folks. Here's another one from my friends over at Now the End Begins, a recent article titled, Pride Month 2023 is shaping up to be the most contentious one ever as the corporate world aims to silence Christians and conservatives. And here's a recent tweet over on Twitter from Oreo Cookie. I'm sure you guys know about Oreo. I mean, I used to love Oreos. They recently put this on Twitter. We're kicking off Pride Month early with a shout out to our longtime partner at PFLAG, whose work continues to support LGBTQ+ people and those who love them. We appreciate you. Another one in recently from the New York Post. Disney promotes first ever Pride Night on Twitter after DeSantis' warning. Disneyland announced its first ever Pride Night at its California theme park recently. Here's another one just in from Fox News. DC Library plans children's Pride Parade for all kids zero, so basically just born, to 18 years old. We want this to be an event for every family. Now we're planning children's Pride Parades. Here's another one just in from Fox News. Pride Month, local governments host drag queen story hour events across the entire country. Another one recently in from the Philadelphia Inquirer. I'm right near Philadelphia, so I wanted to share this one with you guys. Pennsylvania's largest pride flag comes to Philly ahead of weekend's march and festival. The flag is 200 feet long, about the length of some city blocks or two-thirds of a football field. That's insane, folks. And there's even other cities and other countries that are kind of competing to see who can have the biggest pride flag. So they want to make the pride flags basically bigger than the U.S. flag. Pure insanity. This is also dealing with our pets too, folks. I mean, this is pretty nuts. Here's a recent
post from Milkbone. I'm sure you guys use Milkbones for the bones and for the treats. They actually have now pride-themed dog treats. Here's one recently in from the Daily Mail. PetSmart, I'm sure you guys know about PetSmart, huge pet retailer, becomes the latest company to be slammed for LGBTQ pride merchandise for dogs and cats that include bikinis and tutus. Here's another one just in from the New York Post. Target loses $9 billion in week following boycott calls over LGBTQ-friendly kids' clothing. And here's another one just in from Breitbart. I'm sure you guys know about what's going on with Bud Light right now and how much their business has tanked since all this started. Article titled, Bud Light Sponsors Cincinnati Pride Parade as Sales Plummet with Boycott.
Again, time does not permit me to go over all the stories right now, but folks, it is insane. It is off the charts, and it's happening all over the world. So you have major corporations coming out with pride clothes. Again, time does not permit me to go over all the stories, but it is insane. It is off the charts, and it's happening all over the world. And we're seeing all the tension that's causing. All the businesses that are, you know, plummeting because they're deciding to promote this. The major issues coming out from all of this. And the amazing thing is we have these major corporations coming out with pride clothes and merchandise for babies and for kids. You have pride parades for just children happening all over the world. And even our pets are getting bones and apparel for Pride Month. I mean, folks, without a shadow of a doubt, I think it's safe to say we are living as it was in the days of Noah and as it was in the days of Lot. I mean, in the book of Matthew, chapter 24, verse 37 to 39, the Lord Jesus Christ says the following, "But as the days of Noah were, so shall also the coming of the Son of Man be. For as in the days that were before the flood, they were eating and drinking, marrying and giving in marriage until the day that Noah entered the ark, and knew not until the flood came and took them all away, so shall also the coming of the Son of Man be." So Jesus was pointing out that although the people of Noah's day were totally depraved, they were not the least bit concerned about it. They were carrying on the events of their lives without a single thought of the judgment of God. That's what we're seeing, folks. All this craziness is going on. But people are still buying, they're still selling, they're marrying and giving in marriage. It's business as usual, despite all the insanity. And in the book of Luke, chapter 17, verse 26 to 30, this is Luke's account, the Lord Jesus Christ says the following, "And as it was in the days of Noah, so shall it be also in the days of the Son of Man. They did eat, they drank, they married wives, they were given in marriage until the day that Noah entered into the ark and the flood came and destroyed them all. Likewise, also as it was in the days of Lot, they did eat, they drank, they bought, they sold, they planted, they builded. But the same day that Lot went out of Sodom, it rained fire and brimstone from heaven and destroyed them all. Even thus shall it be in the day when the Son of Man is revealed." So we're very clearly told in the days of Noah and in the days of Lot that business was going on as usual. People were marrying, giving in marriage, buying, selling. Again, normalcy, business as usual, despite all the pure insanity going on around them, it was simply normalcy during that time. And that's when the flood came in the days of Noah. And then in the days of Lot, again, that was a state of the world when fire and brimstone came from heaven and destroyed them all. But what were the days of Noah and Lot like? Because we have to understand that. As we look at both the days of Noah and Lot, it is imperative that we fully grasp the obvious parallels between those days and the days in which we live today. Scripture has provided signs of the last days by means of world conditions that will crescendo up to and after the rapture of every born-again believer. They will worsen through the seven-year tribulation period and will end at his glorious second coming. By linking the conditions of both the days of Noah and Lot, Jesus himself reveals that violence, wickedness, sexual depravity, and homosexuality will not simply be in the world, but will fill the earth all at one time in the days leading up to his return. Those conditions are here, and they're building rapidly, folks. I mean, in the days of Noah, we see in the book of Genesis, chapter 6, verse 11 to 13, the following. The earth also was corrupt before God, and the earth was filled with violence. And God looked upon the earth, and behold, it was corrupt, for all flesh had corrupted his way upon the earth. And God said unto Noah, the end of all flesh has come before me, for the earth is filled with violence through them, and behold, I will destroy them with the earth. Today, because man has turned from God, hatred is fueling men's hearts, resulting in bombings and shootings in schools, theaters, malls, the workplace, and public events. An atmosphere of lawlessness is emerging as law enforcement is under attack. Tension between races is explosive. Crime is on the rise, and murder statistics are sharply increasing. Across the globe, savagery and bloodshed are escalating. Homosexuality is legalized. The transgender lifestyle is encouraged and awarded. Fornication is excused. The murderous act of abortion is readily accepted. The entertainment industry media glorifies the dark and vulgar themes of violence and sexual depravity, while the voice of true Christianity is being silenced. And when you go to the days of Lot, especially in the book of Jude, when you go down to verse 7, we read this: even as Sodom and Gomorrah, and the cities about them in like manner, giving themselves over to fornication and going after strange flesh, are set forth an example, suffering the vengeance of eternal fire. The main point I want to make, folks, is this. This June 2023, which we're in right now, is looking to be the most celebrated, explosive, and controversial Pride Month we have ever had. And this is a huge end time sign that we are witnessing right now. We are living as it was in the days of Noah and as it was in the days of Lot. And Jesus makes it very clear that when he returns, that will be the state of the world, as it was in the days of Noah and as it was in the days of Lot. Life was going on. Again, people were buying, marrying, giving in marriage, selling, despite all the insanity going on. Despite all the craziness and wickedness all over the world going on, people were still living life, and there was still a sense of normalcy despite all the craziness. And then judgment came. But right before, in Noah's day, before the flood came, we see Noah, we see Noah's wife, we see Noah's three sons, Shem, Ham, and Japheth, and their wives were all put on the ark. The door was shut. Then the judgment of God came upon humanity. Those in the ark were spared. In the days of Lot, we see Lot's wife, Lot's two daughters, that were taken by the angels, and they were taken to safety. I mean, we know Lot's wife looked back and she became a pillar of salt. However, Lot and his two daughters were spared from the destruction of Sodom and Gomorrah. So just like we see an example there of a rescue, a protection before destruction, likewise, just like in the days of Noah and just like it was in the days of Lot, those of us that are born again believers in Jesus Christ, we will be spared, we will be rescued, we will be raptured before the coming horrific tribulation period begins on the earth. And all I can tell you is if you're watching this video right now and you do not have Jesus Christ in your life, just look around the world right now at everything occurring and look at what your Bible says. You will see several things are true. The Bible is real. The Bible is alive. Jesus is real. Jesus is alive. And Jesus is coming back, and he is coming back one day very, very, very soon. This current world order, it is sinking, and it is sinking fast, just like the Titanic. You need to board the ark right now. You need to enter in through the one door to safety, which is the Lord Jesus Christ. What do you have to do to be saved? The gospel of your salvation is found in the book of 1 Corinthians, chapter 15, verse 1 to 4. Believe. You're believing Jesus Christ died on the cross for your sins. The sin that you could never pay on your own, Jesus Christ paid it in full with his blood on the cross, so you could be reconciled back to him, forgiven of your sins, and be with him forever in heaven. So you're believing Jesus Christ died on the cross for your sins. He was buried, and he rose again. He resurrected on the third day, as it is written in the scriptures. That's the gospel of your salvation. If you're still confused, here's the bottom line. Every single one of us is a sinner. We all miss the mark. We all fall short of the glory of God. And our sin separates us from a holy, a just, and a perfect God. But God loves you so much that he would come down. He would be born of a virgin. He became flesh. He dwelt among us, and he was brutally tortured and crucified and shed his precious blood for you on that cross at Calvary. Again, the sin debt that you could never pay on your own, Jesus Christ paid it in full with his blood on the cross so you could be reconciled back to him, forgiven of your sins, and be with him forever in heaven. That is love, my friends. That is love. The bottom line is this. Heaven and hell are very real, literal places, and you will spend an eternity in one of those destinations. Hell's a real place. It's eternal torment. It's eternal separation from God. I don't want you to go there. Jesus does not want you to go there. But if you die without Jesus Christ, you will be separated from God for eternity in hell, and I am going to tell you the truth because I love you. Jesus Christ is the only way to the kingdom of heaven, and he's the only name that can save you. I am begging you. I am imploring you to get saved right now. Put your faith and your trust in the blood of Jesus right now. Believe Jesus Christ died on the cross for your sins. He was buried, and he rose again. He resurrected on the third day, as it is written in the scriptures, and do it now, because tomorrow is not promised. And make no mistake about it, Jesus is coming, and he's coming one day, very, very, very soon. Keep looking up, keep watching with me, and God bless you all.